Are you lost in the mid-game of OSRS? You just can't really figure out what to do. What's the most worthwhile thing I can do to progress? Let me try to help you with that. I made a list today. Hey everybody, and welcome back to the We Skill Now YouTube channel. I'm a guy that's been playing the game for a while, and I like to think about the game and then talk about it on YouTube. While I've got you, please take a second to click over to the YouTube page and click the subscribe button. Now, what's the purpose of this video? It was not very long ago that I was live on Twitch and I got a couple of questions on my caller-driven advice show, We Talk Now, that were back to back asking the same thing. And they didn't use the same words, but the philosophy behind their question was the same thing. It was, hey, I'm stuck in the mid game. How do I get to the end game? What do I do? What are some worthwhile tasks that I can take on? And I thought, maybe I need to make some kind of resource. maybe I can make some suggestions in a video that I could point people to. So this is that video. Now, how do I want you to use this list? It's not as a way to judge your own account or other people's accounts. It's not if you mark off this entire list, you're officially an endgame player or something like that. This is for people who are lost. And I get it, it's a sandbox game. There's a lot of ways to go to take your account. You can get lost in one rabbit hole or another. And sometimes you're spending a long time on content that doesn't unlock very much for your account. So I wanted to take some time to make a list for mid-game players to help you get to the end game that will focus you on unlocking a lot of stuff and giving yourself access to exploring the game and then going on the grinds that you want to go on. Now, how should you use this video? Well, let me make a suggestion here. I think it's really powerful to write down your goals, but then also write down when you want to accomplish your goals so that you do it. Now, it would make me feel really amazing if you went to the comment section, write down the step that you are on, and then come back after you've completed your goal and let me know that you completed it. That'd be incredible. I would love that. Now, endgame players, if you've completed every single thing on this list already, let me know how this list could be improved in the comments, and I'd really appreciate that feedback. Now, let's get into this list. Welcome to the top 10 goals for mid-game players to get you into the end game. Let's go. Number one. All right, you just got off Tutorial Island. You just beat Elvarg. You got some stuff, but you suck. Okay, number one is to make you suck a little bit less. Let's get you to 1500 total skill just right off the bat. I know that you've got some low skills. You haven't touched runecrafting yet. You've been neglecting thieving, even though like it's not that hard of a skill, but your skills are just too low. Get them up to 1500 and that'll open up some doors for you. You'll be less likely to have to pause in case you get to a quest that you don't have a skill level for, and you might just find yourself catching yourself in a groove. And if you train a certain skill a lot, it'll help you with some other things on this list as well. Now, what are the other things on this list? Let's go over to number two. Get yourself Barrows Gloves. Seriously, come on. It's just recipe for disaster. You've been playing for long enough. It's time to go get Barrows Gloves because these are really, really strong. You use them for almost everything until you get like way later in the game and then you get like really specialized equipment. Get yourself Barrows Gloves. Seriously, it is worth it and you will thank yourself. And I know it's a long quest, but please, just get started. Come on. Come on. Just get started. Number three on this list is to get yourself up to base 50s in your all of your skills. 50 is a really good round number. I love it. It means that you have 100k experience in every skill, and you really have now gotten like a flavor of what all the skills are like. So I really like going for base 50s. So that's why that's on this list. Now, number four. For a mid-game goal, boom, get yourself a fire cape. Now, experienced players are gonna be ripping their hair out. They're like, wait a minute, how is this like not the first thing on this list? You're not a mid-game player until you have a fire cape. Well, it takes some people longer than others, okay? talking about me, of course. but I've got Jad on this list. I've got Jad as the picture and not the actual fire cape. Jad, this scary big red guy, used to be considered the boss of RuneScape, right? He spent a long time being the highest level monster in the entire game. But now he's kind of mid-game content, and he unlocks for you, once you beat him, a fire cape. Fire capes are so important for PvM, melee, and you're gonna feel really, really satisfied when you get this fire cape, and you're just gonna use it a lot. So seriously, yeah, go get the fire cape. Number 5. Now, some people might consider this a big jump in difficulty. There's going to be considerably larger jumps in difficulty in this list compared to the early game list. But I would suggest maybe it's time to go get yourself a skill cape. Now, don't go and do anything crazy. You're not going to shoot for 99 Slayer right away. But that's why I've got the suggestion on there on the picture of 99 Fletching. Notice it's an untrimmed cape. I definitely have bias toward this skill. Almost always the first 99 that I get on any of my accounts is Fletching for some reason. I don't really know why. But it's time to go on some skilling adventures. See if you can't get into a rhythm and just kind of grind out the experience to feel a really big victory in your RuneScape journey. I consider getting level 99s to be some of the most satisfying things you can do in the entire game. I personally love it. Now, what are my suggestions for some skills that are like not too hard and that would make them pretty good candidates for your first 99? Well, how about Fletching, Cooking, Thieving is a potential one, but a lot of people, I guess, have a lot of difficulty with that one. Fire Making is a really awesome first 99 as well. And at the end of the day, tons of these, if you just put your mind to them, you can do it. But there are some that are easier than others. I think especially, you know, Fletching, Cooking, and Fire Making, those are probably like the big three, like easiest ones. So maybe go for one of those. Number 6. I suggest that you should make it a point to go get your first green money stack. Now, if you're an early game player, you don't know what a green money stack is. When you get 10 mil of an item in RuneScape, the number next to it actually turns green. So I'm suggesting you go get 10 mil in a giant pile just so you can sit and stare at it. This is gonna open some doors for you in case you have a Slayer task that comes up and you need some new gear. You wanna have some money in the bank so you can go and do those things and not just like run into an obstacle of like, oh, I don't have the money, now I'm stuck. Go get some money. Number 7, go get a quest cape. Now I know I've got Barrow Gloves and quest cape on this same list. It's kind of interesting because you can't get the quest cape unless you go do the thing that's required for Barrow's Gloves. But this is deeper on the list. This list is kind of designed to be easier at the front, harder in the back. Some people would say that you've completed the game finally when you get a quest cape. Because like this is all the content of the game. You get a bunch of stories from the quest cape. You also get to unlock a whole bunch of stuff. You get to unlock all the areas, see a bunch of content, and it's just really important for your account progression in general. Many doors will be open to you once you have a quest cape. Number 8, maybe it's time to consider doing some bosses. And I don't have Zulrah on here by mistake. Like, Zulrah is not that hard. You're a mid-game player, and that actually includes a lot of different levels. So if you're like, you know, 70s in all of your combat skills, maybe Zulrah's not, you're not ready for Zulrah. Train that up a little bit, maybe head on over to Nightmare Zone, get some levels. But if you've got the quest cape already, which was number 7, you've done Vorkath before. And maybe it's not the most efficient thing to be doing bosses, but I would encourage you not to just play the game to do the most efficient thing all the time, every time. Have some fun, you know? And the lower your level is, if you go and accomplish killing it, that's gonna maybe be the most fun that you have because it's gonna become less and less of a challenge over time. That said, don't spend hundreds of hours like going for the pet on these bosses. At a low level, you're definitely going to want to spend some time investing in your skills first before like doing some serious boss grinds, but you can get it started at this point, right? And I think you're just dipping your toes into different pieces of content to find what might strike your interest. What are you going to go for? And what are you going to enjoy? Just check out this content at this point. Look at some bosses. Number 9, go and do the hard diaries. Probably every single one. And there's a few of these diaries that the elite is actually not that hard to do either. Man, you know, I'm looking at my diary list and I just found out that I'm still a mid-game player. But I guess don't take it from me. But it is really good to do these diaries to get these rewards and possibly do a few of the elite ones as well. You can kind of look at mine and see which elite ones are really easy. Apparently, that definitely includes Karumja and Lumbridge. But I did those elites because I specifically wanted the rewards. The Karumja glove elites are... The elite gloves are amazing. I love being able to use fairy rings without the staff. And, you know, you get all kinds of rewards from every single one of these. They're all worth it. Go and do some hard diaries. Do a few elite diaries as well. And then here we are in number 10. You almost certainly will have a few of these things before this point, but go ahead and get yourself some untradeables. You know, you're going to want to get that Slayer Helm grind out of the way. Elite Void, honestly, a little bit of a pain to play that much pest control, I know from experience, but those are really important items for you. And they'll especially help you in bossing at some point. Alright guys, that's it for the top 10 goals for mid-game players to make it into the endgame. I didn't realize I was going to be making the discovery that I actually am a mid-game player in this video, but hey, fine. You know, that's how it is. Looks like after I get done recording this video, we're going to have to focus on grinding out these diaries, because I guess that's the step that I'm on. Now, if you want to discuss these things further and you'd rather do it live, hey, I stream on Twitch. If you want to ask me a question anytime or interact or something, follow me on Twitter. I would really appreciate seeing that number going up. And right now I've got way too many followers on Twitter that play Mario and not enough that play RuneScape. So I'd like to balance that out and get more RuneScape stuff on my feed. So follow me over on Twitter. I've got other links in the description, like including my Discord and my subreddit. So you can check any of those things out that you want. Now please, if you've watched this far in the video, take a second to click the subscribe button. I would appreciate it so much and have a great day, all right?